All right, guys, today we are working on the stereo upgrade for the Alfa Romeo Giulia. It's a 2019 Q4. And let's see if I can turn this thing around. So here we go. That's the Alfa Romeo Giulia. We got the trunk open. We started a little bit so far. So what we are doing, we have taken the back carpet out. We've taken the back styrofoam sound dampening piece out. There's our battery, there's our fuse box. So we are going to put the amp right here, the line converter right there. We'll put a 12 inch sub right there behind the seat facing forward. And this plastic sound deadening piece, we had to cut the bottom off of that. You can see there's the bottom piece. So this just sat right on there like that, and we just cut that thing off. So this will sit right back down in here, just like that. Leaves that hole open. One, with that piece down in there, it would push down on the amp, and the styrofoam wouldn't go all the way down. Plus, having that open hole, it's gonna allow a little bit of cooling in there. So I'll start the next video on the next step. We are going to take this little piece off. There's a T25 Allen wrench, or sorry, Torx bit screw that goes there. Back here, there is a plastic in this hole right there. There's just a little plastic 10 millimeter nut. You can take that off. Then you'll need to pop off your hood release handle, which looks like this. Just pops straight out. It's got a couple of little clips on it you can see right there. So just put your plastic pry tool behind that and you can just pry that straight out. And then you should be able to access this. And you can see where your trunk release connects right back here. So you'll disconnect that. And then you've got access to those wires. So we can find the speaker wires we need to tap into. We did a bunch of this, put some of the stuff back together. Got a little overexcited and forgot about the video. So what we did, we popped this plastic kick panel piece off. This piece comes off. There's a screw under here. And then there's just a little black plastic nut under this cap. You can just pry that off, unscrew that nut. So back here on the right side, we tapped into the right speaker wire. Tapped into the purple wire for the positive, purple with an orange stripe for the negative. And then on the driver's side, we tapped into a yellow wire and then a yellow with a black stripe for the positive and negative. Ran those all the way underneath here, ran them behind this plastic piece here. Ran it under here, we pulled this plastic piece off. There's a screw back here, you just pop this off. Pulled this piece of the seat off right here, it just pulls straight out. Ran the speaker wires back there. So here is our speaker wires coming from the right speaker. The ones coming from the left speaker. And we also installed a remote gain control that we just mounted up underneath the dash. So wrapped all these with Tessa tape. This is the subwoofer speaker wire. So we've got those wrapped, runs under this little black plastic piece or styrofoam piece. And so what we did in the back here. All right, so we ran this all under the styrofoam piece in here. We took just a black piece of wood, put some foam underneath, and used some 1x2s. To make risers for the amp and the digital signal processor. So we've got our power, our ground, our remote. We got our fuse back here. Coming out of the fuse box, we just tapped into that. We just piggybacked on the one that comes from the battery. You see right there, the one from the battery is underneath. That just pops back on. All right, so we've got our fuse there, 100 amp fuse, because we're running a 600 watt amp. And we've got a couple distribution blocks down there, one for the ground, one for the power, one One for the power obviously runs to both of these, same with the ground. We'll tune these next with an oscilloscope, make sure that our signal is coming out correctly, and then we'll hook the sub up to it and see how it sounds. All right, we got the install all done. Wife's in there, she's gonna start the car up. So this little plastic thing that was right up here that proved to cause little vibrations, so we just ripped that thing out. Let's little airflow through anyway. So there's the sub. It is facing forward. She's gonna kick it on here in just a second. Throw this little plastic thing over there. So the outside rattles just a little bit. We'll have to put some Dynamat down. Probably end up Dynamatting the whole trunk in here. But inside it sounds great. Let's crank the volume up a little bit. And there you go, it's all done.